First responders in Cleveland are training just in case they have to transport a patient who might have the Ebola virus. Today, medics demonstrated the steps of putting on and taking off their protective suits recommended by the CDC. Our Paul Kiska watched that demonstration. And Paul, this was really an eye-opening experience.
Well, it really was just that, Lee. Medics who work for Cleveland EMS showed us what goes into wearing those protective suits. It's a 25-step process, choreographed slowly and with precision.
It was something that never crossed my mind, but trained EMS workers know the first precaution starts before the suit even goes on.
You're supposed to go ahead and take off anything that could potentially puncture, rip, or tear the suit while putting it on. That includes all jewelry, keys, watches, or anything sharp, pens, pencils inside of the pockets.
A partner helps put the TICHEM impermeable suit on. Rubber booties get covered with rubber boots, then the seams are taped.
And before I finish that off, I'm going to go ahead and flip over a tab, so when they take off the suit, they have a point where they can start and pull that off.
Medical gloves and seams also taped. Rubber gloves and more tape. Face masks, a hood, and tape off the neck. Then the crucial part, taking off the suit, which could be contaminated. Medics and hospital staff would actually be standing in a biohazard container for this part. Notice the hands remain up while the person is sprayed with the decontaminant.
If he puts his hands down, that water runoff or substance runoff will then run onto his glove.
Another tense moment. No one wants to trip while stepping out of the suit with two boots on each foot. Watch closely.
Left foot forward. Just make sure. Good.
Face masks come off slowly. Then what I thought was the key moment, removing the medical gloves.
We'll pinch the outside of the glove, we'll pull that off over onto itself, and then we'll take our fingers and run it on the inside of the glove and remove that, making sure we do not snap the gloves. And then that will also go into a biohazard bag.
Want to mention they use the buddy system so the partner would actually be wearing a suit during a real call. I asked the paramedics, what's the hardest part of being in those protective suits? They said they're so used to rushing to and during emergencies, but when putting on those suits in this situation, they have to keep reminding each other to go slow to avoid mistakes.
Yeah, wow, and you can sure see that when they're taking off those gloves, Paul. I understand you had a chance to experience what it's like to wear one of those suits.
Yeah, for a little bit, Lee, medics Nick Sayer and Chuck Kelly helped me get into one of those suits, so take a look.
The Cleveland EMS guys helped me don this hazmat suit, minus the tape just to speed things up, but a little bit warm in the suit, but I do feel like I have free range of motion. I can move around pretty easily. It's actually pretty comfortable, a little warm around the mask, but I do feel secure.
And that mask does steam up a bit, making it a little difficult to see. So a lot more to that job than you think, like most jobs. In the newsroom, Paul Kiska, News Channel 5.